ideal qualities of a judge, for a judge?
I would suggest that first and foremost, he must have an integrity of character, independence of mind, and courage to stick to the principles, to abide by the Constitution. As far as the merits are concerned, of course, he must know the law, the Constitution, and particularly the philosophy of the Constitution. But if he is in any way deficient in law, the feed comes from the lawyers on both sides, but you can't get a feed of integrity from lawyers and legal community. So I would first and foremost give importance to the character of the individual. And I would suggest for that purpose that this commission, before making recommendation, should publish the name of the candidates.
That they're proposing
at least 2 months in advance, so that if there is any objection to his being appointed from the public, the people can send their objections to the commission and they should consider them.
But this provision is not there.
It will all depend upon the rules and regulations that the commission makes.
Right, right.
For the procedure that they are going to follow. In appointment.
So that possibility exists?
There's possibility is there. We can also insist that they should do it. And I think there will be no objection. That is only when they select, they should publicize the names.
So your book, The Grammar of Democracy, has gone into 3 editions, I think. And it's also been published in Hindi and Marathi. The entire effort in that book has been to see how democracy should deepen in our country, not just in our country, but democracy as a concept. So the electoral democracy, which has now got captured by a few interests, should get more broad-based and wide-based, and our institutions should get a greater sense of democracy. How would you sum up what you've written in that book?
I have written that book to enlighten the people that what we have is not a substantive democracy, but a formal, and more particularly only electoral democracy. Even that electoral democracy is partial, because at least 99.9% of our population cannot contest the election. They can only vote for the candidates. So we want an electoral system to be also pro-people. Today only the money bags can constitute, or the muscle men. That should go. And unless therefore we ensure that everybody who wants to serve the people, who is honest, selfless, and who wants to contest elections, should be in a position to contest the election. As long as we do not ensure it, we cannot say that we have a truly representative democracy. Secondly, I have pointed out, even today, we have democratic rights. Unless the affairs of the country are governed by the wishes of the people, you cannot say you have a democratic government. For that purpose, therefore, we must have a participation of the citizenry in day-to-day governance of the country.
Day-to-day policy matters.
Exactly, day-to-day governance. And that can be ensured if people collectively exercise the democratic rights which are given. Those democratic rights are to express their opinion through public rallies, to make demonstrations.
Right to protest, peaceful assembly.
To protest by non-violent means and come out with their charter of demands and require the executive to comply with their charter of demands. This right is there with the people, and they can of course exercise it only through collective efforts.
So thank you, Justice Sawant, for being with us on the show and for illuminating us on so many critical questions. Thank you very much.
Thank you.